Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Stealwing 33 Plays Enter the Gungeon. I'm Stealwing 33. Today, I think we're playing as the convict today. I think that's the MO today. I don't remember who the last character we play as, so there we go. Oh, it was the Marine, because we had that really good run where I surprised Scoblin, because I suddenly blew it out of the water on the second run of the day. We're back. We're back playing Gungeon. It is presently Monday. I'm sorry that the videos are a little delayed today because I had a pretty busy weekend, so I was unfortunately unable to record over the weekend like I hit the Q button on accident. I was unfortunately unable to record over the weekend like I normally do. So I'm now recording on Monday, which means that there's going to be double videos tomorrow on Tuesday. Which, you know, hopefully no one's going to complain about too much, because, you know, frankly, I think that it's still the same number of videos, it's just laid out a little bit differently, which I don't think is that big of a deal, to be honest, but, you know, if that's a problem, take it up with HR. I'm sure that somebody somewhere will care. You know, the complaint department will hear your requests at a later date, etc., etc. But we're doing alright so far. I really, really hate the trusty sidearm, I think is what she has. The budget revolver. Really hate the budget revolver. Ooh, it's got an uncapped fire rate. I did not know that. That makes the budget revolver slightly better. The budget revolver just got like a really long reload, and it also has like a really small clip capacity, and it doesn't do like extra damage or anything like that. It makes it kind of rough to use. Probably my least favorite of all of the, what's it called? The sidearms. I got trapped up against the wall for a second there. Alright. Oh, I should probably go to the shop while I'm thinking about it. Totally didn't notice that the shop was even open down here. But hopefully it'll be fine. There's a key. Fabulous. Let's go ahead and put that open. There we go. And we should be good. Alright. Fabulous. This one's going pretty well so far. I haven't gotten hit yet. I accidentally used a blank, but that's not a big deal. I mean, it will be in, like, you know, like 3 minutes when I accidentally, like, when I'm fighting the boss and I go to use the second blank and it's not there and I end up getting shot. But that'll just be funny. I mean, that'll be great, won't it? Those are just our luck. Basically. Well, we got that health back immediately. Not bad. Not bad. Green chest. Not a mimic. It's... What is that? Muscle relaxant? Oh! Muscle relaxant. Muscle relaxant's super good. Because as you can see, it basically makes the sawed-off overpowered. It makes it one of the better starting weapons in the game. It'll make a whole host of other weapons super good. And now we know that the other chest on the map is a gun, so we'll be able to pop that open and get that squared away real quick, which is fine. But as you can see, the sawed-off's becoming—it's a destruction derby when you got the muscle relaxants, because it causes the already sort of accurate sawed-off to become even more accurate. Making it a stream of bullets rather than a cone of bullets. Which is great, because, you know, that's the shotgun's biggest problem is that as you get later in the game, they become less and less good over time because the getting close to people thing becomes a problem. So, you know, I'm pretty pleased about it. It also makes the budget revolver slightly better. A gun that's already kind of accurate, becoming more accurate, is still pretty good. Muscle relaxant is actually really good with the pilot, actually. The kind of thing that you don't really think about. Well, I mean, I think about it constantly because I fucking hate the Rogue 7. Is probably my least favorite gun in the game. We got the Corsair, which isn't bad, per se. Definitely not my favorite gun in the game, but it's definitely not bad. It's good for... It'll be good against the boss. It's definitely better than trying to use the sawed-off. Granted, the sawed-off is more accurate now, so it's not bad. I think the big problem we're going to have here is that the Corsair's good because of, like, some of, like, the mechanically stuff about it. Like, the fact that the bullets bounce, for a very, very long time, actually. So they can hit the boss multiple times. But, the problem we're running into is one of volume, right? So, I got hit. Okay, well, there goes that. The Bullet King's super aggressive today for some reason. It's attacking, like, a lot. I'm not sure what's up with that, but it feels extra aggressive. Maybe a patch went through at some point that made him harder. Which, you know, sounds about right. It's been like a week since I've actually looked at any patch notes for Gungeon at all. I might have been better off just using the sawed off during that entire boss fight, but that's alright. We got the pitchfork. I will grab this for the sawed off, grab that. We're back at full health, so I'm not really any worse for wear. The pitchfork's it's an weapon. It sucks that we can't go down to the oubliette, although that might be sparing us a little bit of dying, but, you know, whatever. We should be fine. Taking a little sip of my iron brew. My Scottish cola that, I get once a year. I get it during the summer when I work at ID Tech. Started when I was dating a girl named Ashley. Ashley loved the Scottish games because she is very Scottish. And so she was telling me about this weird soda that she liked. And the first time I bought it, I got it because I got it as a treat for her because she was coming into the city to see me. And I thought it would be a nice surprise, that kind of thing. And then turns out I really liked it. I didn't like it at first, actually, because I don't really like the kind of cola it is. It's not a caramel based soda. It's like an orange based soda, like a fruit based soda, and it kind of tastes like a creamsicle. It's actually pretty good. It's become one of my favorite non Pepsi based colas. There are things that I like. This is one of them. But like I said, I only really get it once a year, so it's like my special thing I do every summer. God, the sawed-off's already bad, which is mildly upsetting. But, you know, it's fine. Go ahead and fireball that guy. We're doing well so far. The Corsair's not... son of a bitch. The Corsair's not the kind of... The Corsair and the Pitchfork are not the guns that I would have picked to have ever. Don't get me wrong, I like the Corsair, and I think it's, like, not a bad weapon. But the problem is that it's not fantastic. Like, by any stretch of the imagination. It doesn't do good on-hit damage, and a lot of its damage comes from its effect damage, which is fine, but, you know, it's not what I would want. Blue Guanstone, not bad. Time is on my side. I think that's every time there's an explosion, we get slow-mo, or something like that. Oh, every time we get hit, we get slow-mo. That'll be nice against the Lich fight later, which, you know, it will be fine, but I would have preferred to have gotten a better weapon. Hopefully we'll end up with a key at some point. I know we bought the only key from our shop, so that's gonna be a non-helpful entity right there. But hopefully at some point maybe it'll be fine, but that point is not today. The semi-homing from the Corsair is not bad. Extra blank is not bad. And we got pitchfork ammo, I guess. I don't like being in a position where the pitchfork is the best gun we have. I don't find that very pleasant. Don't get me wrong, the pitchfork's great on rooms with pits, but, you know, I don't like banking on pits and stuff. to be the thing that's going to make a gun, like, good at all. Because, you know, they're unreliable on a good day. The same reason I don't like relying on, like, table techs and stuff. I don't find the table techs to be very good. Granted, you know, I'm open to being incorrect, but I think the subreddit and the community at large seem to agree with me. Hopefully we end up with another key, because I'd really like to get into that chest. A green quality gun would be very good right now. Very good. But we'll see. I mean, worst case scenario, we'll deal with what we got, but, I mean, I'd really rather not have to deal with, like, the Corsair being our primary weapon for much longer if I can avoid it. Yeah, that would be kind of nice. Right. I will say that the pitchfork is super good against these, like, smaller enemies like this. Anything that breaks apart into smaller entities, like the Blobulons and stuff, the pitchfork's super good against them, because, reasons. I'm gonna go with reasons on that one. But, you know, the piercing's nice. It does do damage, which, you know, can't be said for all of the piercing weapons in the game. That's not all the elemental effect ones. Like, the science engine. Science engine's bad. It's science cannon, I think is what it's called, where it, like, shoots that beam, and then, like, the beam causes elemental effects on people over time. That one's pretty bad, to be honest. Ooh, nice, a key. That key will hopefully give us a gun that I can use effectively. What do we get? The fucking face melter. Alright, really not in a good way right now. The face melter is not the kind of gun that I would have liked. The face melter is not bad, but it's just not super great. We definitely need something that, like, I can use on bosses at this point, because, like, I've got plenty of guns that, like, aren't bad, but face melters is middling at best, terrible at worst. It requires me to split my focus a little bit too much, trying to remember where I'm gonna put down, like, the you know, the extra thing from, like, the reload, the amplifier and stuff. Although, granted, it is super good against the Amoconda, if I'm actually paying attention and don't accidentally run into the goddamn Amoconda balls all over the place. Mostly because the Amoconda, like, runs into it after a while, so it's really easy to, like, just pelt the shit out of it with full tabs of it. We're going down to the next floor without any good guns, any health upgrades. But I got armor. I got that going for me. So, you know, fuck me, I guess. I don't know, man. This isn't shaping up super well. Granted, we've made decent progress, but I don't know. The Brick Breaker is not the gun that I would have... It's also not a gun that I would have normally picked out of a lineup. The Brick Breaker, much like the Corsair, gets a lot of its oomph out of being a bouncy weapon. But that's not necessarily a good thing. 200 turtle shells is a lot of turtle shells. But you know, it's not enough turtle shell. The turtle shells individually don't do enough damage to, like, get me super hyped about it. Granted, if you do have shock. Shock shots, along with the Brick Breaker, that's a really good synergy, because the shells do chain lightning to one another, and the lightning does pretty decent damage, if I remember correctly. The Brick Breaker is pretty good against large enemies, that's the only, like, upside to it I can really think of. This is a different, this is a new room. I've never seen this room before in my entire life. God damn it. Well, we revealed the secret room. I'm not sure where it is, but I heard the noise that's associated with it. A lot of chaos and a lot of shottage going on in here. And we got a key. I thought I heard us reveal a secret room. Maybe I was wrong. That's alright. We got this, which we got hip holster. Hip holster makes the Corsair actually kind of crazy. Hip holster is every time we reload, we fire a shot from the gun that we're currently using. So, like, you kind of see, like, so I fired double Corsair rounds, basically, which is pretty good. So, like, we can get some real chaos going here. We basically have 400 Corsair shots right now. If I think about it, like, every shot's a double shot, basically. So, you know, we got that going for us, which is actually pretty good. Now if we can get a better single shot weapon, this would be even more spectacular. But we'll see. Because there's a high chance that I might just die from not paying attention. But I don't know. We'll get to that when we get to that. For now, we're doing fine. I feel like we should fight the boss, but I also kind of want to try to find another weapon before I, like, commit myself to fighting the boss right now. So let's poke around a little bit. Get out of here. I always feel like the pitchfork should have to be reloaded, and then I remember it doesn't have to be reloaded at all. Potion of lead skin is really good. There are no keys in the shop, so that blows. But potion of lead skin is, like, super good. To the point where I actually might buy it. Let's wait, and I want to see if we can find some keys. I'd like to, like, maybe try to see if that's, like, a Locklear shop or something, or a tablet like the Agatha shop or something. I don't know. If it's one of the specialty shops, I might be more interested in that right now than in just, like, the potion of lead skin. There's also a shrine over here. Got him. Alright, we got a blank, which is good. This has a gun muncher in it, so let's go ahead and munch this. And then we'll munch our sawed off as well. Yep, pitchfork, it's alright, but it's not great. And it was almost out of ammo, so. Ooh, the anvilin. That's a gun. This is a gun. I like this one. The anvilin fires giant, piercing anvils that knock people around and deal a bunch of damage. The real trick with the anvilin is to remember that the anvilin also keeps hurting people as it pushes them. So you can have it, run into a target and then have it, like, continue to hurt the target as they get pushed around. And then if I bother to remember to do it, I can also reload between shots, and then fire double anvilin shots, like, at people, which is great. The anvilin does really good base damage, and then it also sometimes deals multiple points of damage, depending on the angle at which you fire it at people. The angle of incident of the anvilin shot is important, but we're doing all right. This is good. This is, gives me confidence. I'm glad we elected to wait to see what we would get. The anvilin also causes a stun when it hits somebody. So if the target doesn't die from it, they'll sometimes get stunned, which is good. It's really good against multi-stage enemies like that one, because you can kill all the stages at once. It's a good gun. It's a one of my more favorite guns in the game, truth be told, I miss you, truth be told I'm lying. The stunning effect is fantastic against some of the smaller enemies in the game. Particularly when we get down to Bullet Hell, the end villain actually comes in real big. We're going to need to make sure that we stay stocked up on ammo, though, because I am using it a little too much, and I want to save some shots for the boss. Granted, the Corsair will also be very good for the boss, but the Corsair can be used on, like, regular rooms where, like, you know, I don't feel like the... I feel like the ant villain's best against the boss fights. There we go. Easy peasy! Lemon squeezy. We're doing all right so far. So far, so good. I mean, don't get me wrong, there is room for improvement in all things, but right now I think we're sitting kind of pretty. I really wish we'd gotten the anvil in much sooner. It's super good against bosses. It's super good in rooms. It's really good just sort of all around. It would have been very helpful against, like, the Amalconda in particular. Would have gotten its shit kicked in by the anvilin. A Bullet King, not so much, but the Amalconda definitely would have keeled. Alright, we're doing fine, though. Just gotta stay... The trick... So, Scoblin asked me how it is that I stay pretty decent at Gungeon. The trick is to kind of keep your back to, like, not where bullets are coming from. It's a lot easier to dodge stuff when you know which side of the room it's coming at you from. And, in particular, it's a lot easier to survive. Right, I was just checking to see if there was a secret room there. It's a lot easier to dodge stuff if you know for a fact that, like, all the bullets are gonna be coming from, like, your left or your right. Actually a boss battle where the, Corsair wouldn't be good, so I'm glad we got the Anvilin. Granted, the Anvilin's not great against, you know, this boss in particular either, but, you know, it's all the moving. The moving's hard. Well, let's fire some Corsair shots. Alright, we got that blank going. We got one more blank left, so... I think we're still sitting kind of pretty here. If we can get this room really opened up, I could probably just, like, try to stay away from Treadnought and just, like, run around the room while the Corsairs, like, pick away at it slowly. It'll also take care of a lot of the ants for us sort of autonomously, which is nice. Yeah, this seems to be working out. That was a surprisingly effective strategy. Yeah, it worked out fine. We're good. Oh, and Master of Unlocking. Master of Unlocking is really good. Is it one of my more favorite items in the game? Yeah, definitely. I kind of wish I had left some areas untouched, actually, because we could actually use Master of Unlocking to get keys, but that's all right. That's alright. We're doing fine. Down to the fourth floor. We're doing pretty good today. I'm feeling pretty confident. So Master of Unlocking, for those of you who do not know, what it does is, as if you don't get hit on X number of rooms, you get a key. Right? Pretty simple item. Doesn't do much. But... the idea there is that, like, I'm pretty good at, like, not getting hurt on most of the rooms that I go on to. I mostly get beat up really bad against bosses, generally speaking, at least. But, like, there you go. See, we got a key. We beat four rooms, we got a key. But we're doing fine. Get out of here. Right. Skeleman is not fun, and I don't like him. But now he's dead, so it doesn't matter. Where is remaining bad man. There he is. And now he's dead. In particular, you know what? The Scalamans, actually, the Anvillains, like, super good against them, because they have... They're really lightweight bad guys. Which means that they get knocked around pretty fast. So, you know, we got that going for us, which is nice. Where is the bad guy? There it is. Where's the other bad guy? There he is. I got him. And we're good. Fantastic. What do we need ammo for? The Corsair could probably use ammo. I'd rather have it for the Anvillain. The Corsair's gonna be doing its job. Even on that much ammo, it's gonna be doing its job, so... I feel pretty good about my choices there. Yeah, the Brick Breaker's not fantastic. It even has trouble, like, killing Bulletkin and stuff, and, you know, I want it to be good, I want to like it, I just can't bring myself to like it, you know. There we go. Easy enough. Are you a mimic? Nope. Alright, what do we got? Ooh, Proton Pack. Proton Pack's... That's pretty legit. Yeah, this is pretty legit in rooms and against bosses. Probably more legit against bosses at this stage in the game than it is against rooms. Don't get me wrong, it's legit against everybody, but in particular, it does really decent damage. It's got a very fast priming rate for a beam weapon. It's got a really good arc. It's got a lot going for it. It's a good gun. Definitely one of those weapons that I'm not mad that I got. Granted, that means that our second chest is going to be a passive of some kind. Which we'll have to see. I don't know how excited I am about that, but, you know, it's fine. Perfect. All right. Whew. Let's go ahead and just... Just go ahead and do that there thing. Boom, easy peasy. Boom, dead. Forget about it. I don't know why I fired that last turtle shell. I didn't need to do that. You know what? Actually, the biter room. This is a great room for the Brick Breaker, because it kills all the biters really fast. And if you can get corner advantage on a bad guy, the Brick Breaker's pretty good. But that's more like a bouncing weapon thing. That's not like a Brick Breaker exclusive thing. That's when you can get bounce advantage. Alright, let's see if we can do this thing as well. Cool, let's do it. Oh, that's interesting. So I can fire multiple bullets at once, huh? Interesting. Let's go ahead and do it like that. Alright, cool. And then we can fire one more right there. That should do it. Hey, not bad. What'd I get? Big ass red chest. Alright. Whoa, yes. The bullet bore. Now, the bullet bore is an interesting weapon. So what it does is it shoots this disky thing, and then the disky thing makes them explode after a while. But it's also a single-shot weapon, which means that it benefits from... What's it called? My hip holster. I don't know how good this thing is against bosses, right? So for me, the real strength comes from the fact that it stuns people, right? Which inspires me to believe that it's, like, a super-duper good room clear. Especially with the hip holster, because it fires two drills at once. Which is broken, a little broken, because of the amount of stunning. All the stunning. So it's a good gun. I'm excited to have it. It'll be very, very good against the boss. I don't think I need to buy keys. So what? Yeah, I was like, I think that there's a thing there, and there was. So let's go ahead and pop this open. Nope, just armor and health, which is also fine. I'm not gonna complain about that. I kind of want to buy the honeycomb, but at the same time, I don't want to invest in something that requires me to get hurt in order for it to work. Getting it on accident's one thing, but like, do I want to do this yet? No, let's wait. Let's wait. Let's see what the passive is, and then we'll try to take down our boss fight here. Depending on the boss, I'll probably end up using something. I don't know what that something's gonna be. But that's all right. We'll just use the Corsair for right now. I just want to kind of save our good weaponry for when we're in boss fights or later in the game here. I can stand to lose like a little bit of this and that every now and then. I'm not sure why the screen's vibrating so violently like that every now and then. It's actually very concerning, but you know, it's fine. You know what? There you go. How about that? How about you suck on them apples, you jerks? I think it might be from the Corsair dying against the wall. The jetpack. So the jetpack's good. That's a toughie. So like the Molotov is very bad against... Let's take the jetpack. It'll make me slightly faster. Make a chest friendship, chest vampirism. Let's do chest friendship. I think that'll be good. The jetpack, the reason I took the jetpack over the Molotov is the Molotov's bad against the High Dragon and the Lich fight. So knowing that, that means that at least two of the next three bosses, it's bad against it. The jetpack, although not super useful, I'm actually super glad I took this now. The jetpack, although not super useful all the time, is super good against this boss and the Lich and a bunch of other stuff. And the reason it's good against this boss is because I can do this during the stage of the fight, which is normally when I end up getting hit. So, you know, not getting hit there is nice. The only thing I gotta remember is that I can't dodge roll while the jetpack's on. So, I gotta be aware of that and plan accordingly here. Alright. The face melter's actually doing a pretty decent job tearing the wallmonger apart, and we did it. We didn't get hit. Face melter came in big in the clutch there, which is great. We got the Void Core Assault Rifle, which is a very, very good gun. Well, it's a good general use gun. It's not very, very good against bosses, and I think it's starting to fall off now, like at floor 5 where we are. But everything should be fine. I'm feeling confident. I'm feeling awake. I'm feeling alert. I'm good to go. I'm really feeling it today, you know. Because sometimes I'm not feeling it, you know. Sometimes I'm playing the Gungeon and I'm like, man, you know. I want to be the guy, you know? But I can't, because I'm playing Gungeon today. But I'm feeling it today. I'm really feeling the Gungeon. I'm having a good time. It's not something that I always have, in particular with Gungeon. I'm not always super pumped about, you know, the way that Gungeon goes. I get a little salty every now and then. Void Core Assault Rifle is, it's performing. Whether or not it's performing admirably remains to be seen. But, I don't know. It's not bad. It's just not, I don't know if it's great yet, you know? I think the speed up from the jetpack might be the best part about the jetpack. Not being able to dodge roll is kind of shit, but, you know, speed up's nice. Makes it super easy for me to, like, dodge people manually, which is already sort of how I do it. So, you know, I got that going for me, which is nice. All right, easy peasy. We're doing pretty good. I think I could use with one more Master of Unlocking proc, and then I think we'll be fine on the fine on that front. We're doing fine. Oh my god, Reaper Man, get out of my way. Lord of the Jammed. Alright, we're fine. I need one more key to feel confident, because then I can open up all of our remaining chests in the game, which will make me feel better. Not necessarily good, mind you, but better. Alright, let's just kill that guy like that. That guy's out of gun ammo. Fire turtle shells. I'm hoping to save the bullet boar for when we go down to bullet hell. If the enemies get stunned up down there, and I end up using all the bullet boar ammo and get through bullet hell without getting hit too much, that'll be pretty good. I'll be pretty good with that, to be honest. But you know, we'll see. The speed up on this is already, like, paying off dividends from the jetpack. I'm already kind of glad that I took the jetpack. I mean, I was already glad I took the jetpack because I ended up fighting the Wallmonger, and it's, like, almost a direct counter to the Wallmonger. Shield of the Maidens. Pretty DiSerono, though. Yeah, I'll take Shield of the Maiden. I like Shield of the Maiden more than jetpack, and jetpack already paid for itself. Already paid for the price of admission. Now, I'm sad to see it go a little bit, but, you know, it's fine. We're fine. Get out of here. This is my town, scrubs. I'm the big boss now. Me, Stealwing, master of the convict. Like grinding myself up against the wall, slowing myself down a little bit there. It sucked. Alright. And villain. Your turn. Oop. Dodge rolled that one. Ha ha! God damn, I say good name. What? Oh, come on. I dodge rolled that. Whoa. See that, that shotgun Kim got grounded in a paste. I really need to stop getting hit so I can get the Master of Unlocking stacks. You know what I really want is I want, like, the Mega Hand of the Heroine again. Like, right now. Just give it to me. Fuck it. Like, I deserve it. I earned it. I made it this far on the garbage heap that they served me. I think I earned it at this point. Get out of here. Give me that armor. Really could use some Master of Unlocking, though. Broccoli. Ooh, Jesus. Broccoli's really good. So it increases your damage by one, gives you health up, gives you an all stats up. It's one of the best items in the game. And it's also one of the last items we bought out of our, out of the shop. So, you know, we got that. But, I'm hoping that we'll end up with enough money as we go through the floor. We gotta get to 190 something. Hopefully we'll be able to make that happen. I'm hopeful. That's a specialty shop. Purple Flame denotes that, I think. I don't actually know. So, we'll find out in a minute. Well, hopefully, if I can get another key, we'll find out in a minute. Can't get another key, well then, you know, fuck me, I guess, but cool. Alright. We're crawling up there. We just need, like, what, 50 more gold? I'm unconfident of our ability to get 50 gold over the course of the floor here. Ow. Especially not playing like that. Fucking garbage factory here. Get out of here. Proton pack. Do your job. Alright. One nut at a time. No gold Skelemans. Maybe I should have let him spawn a Skeleman or something. Maybe. I don't know. The best enemy in the game for that is Bandage Bulletkin Man. The Mind Cutter. That's a good one. The Bandage Bulletkin Man spawns like an actually easy to kill enemy, not the Gold Skeleman enemy. And so you can like farm stuff off of them. I don't think they drop items, but like if you have the Metronome or something like that, you can farm Metronome stacks off of them, which is pretty good. Awesome, we got a second Master of Unlocking stack. Let's go ahead and take a look over here at the specialty shop. Maybe it'll end up being something good. It could even be a boat. Nope, just amulets. We'll check back here. I mean, homing bullets is pretty good. I don't know, I'm not super interested in any of the other items. Is there any more floor left to go? No? Alright, well, I guess we're gonna have to leave broccoli behind. We'll have to hope we get it another time. Alright, time for the high dragon. Let's do this. Yeah, we're just gonna blank out of that. Alright, the trick for the High Dragon fight, by the way, if you're wondering, is you don't need to move your mouse cursor at all. The screen doesn't move like in the other boss fights when you move, so you only need to focus on dodging. And then my advice for dodge rolling is to just dodge roll against the bottom of the screen. You'd be surprised how many attacks you'll dodge by just rolling against the bottom of the screen. I say as, like, you guys watch me, like, take, like, eat 5 fireballs in the back of the head, basically. Which, you know, is hilarious, but... Right. Corsair's really doing a number on the High Dragon, by the way. I don't know if you guys are watching this or not, but, yeah, it's chewing him up pretty bad. Don't get me wrong, I take a beating, but, I take a beating mostly because I'm an idiot, and less because of anything else. We'll probably use the Proton Pack against the Heart. I think it does the most DPS out of all of our guns. Which is good. Doing pretty good. That did a pretty admirable job. I think the Mind Cutter might be faster though. Which, you know, is a thing to keep in mind. Hup, hup, hup. I think it's only better because I can shoot it faster. It might not actually be better. That's right, this phase is actually not that hard to dodge through. You just gotta, like, get good about dodging. Be good about doing the thing. You can kind of see, like, this phase is easier than the first one. There's a lot less chaos and a lot less, like, randomness associated with it. So it's a lot easier to get through without getting hit. That motherfucker's dead. What up, nerd? I'll blow your skull apart with my giant thing. We'll take the obsidian shell. Not that we need it, but, you know, it makes the ending screen look more impressive. Do I want to buy homing bullets? You know, it's my last chance to buy stuff, so I might as well do it. I'm sad we can't buy broccoli. If I could steal it, I would. But I can't, so I won't. Alright, on to the next floor. We'll be using up the bullet bore. Probably against every room until we make it to the boss fight. And then, I don't know what we'll do after that. Figure it out, I guess. I fell in the hole. Ha! There we go. Rolling, rolling, rolling. Go down to bullet helling. going to town now, Rawhide. A lot of this game also comes down to like what kind of guns you get at the beginning of the game. It's really easy to get like super hyper screwed by the fact that you got like just the shittiest weapons ever at the beginning of the game. It's happened. You guys have watched it happen on camera before, where like I'll get a gun at like the beginning of the game. Like I'll get like the trash cannon, which is like literal trash, at the beginning of the game, and just get like fucked by it. Oh, I forgot that we bought homing bullets. There you go. And villain's super good with homing bullets, because of its piercing and a bunch of other stuff. Guns that are worse with homing bullets, anything that requires impact to do well. So things like, I don't know, there are a couple guns. I've pointed them out before. I just can't remember off the top of my head what they are for some reason. I'm getting, like, super hammered on this room. Way too much chaos. Get out of here. Bulletkin room's the easiest room in the game. I'm really hoping that we'll get health at some point. I do not relish the idea of trying to do the rest of this floor with one HP. I don't know. We'll see, I guess. I mean, fuck. Like, I'm running out of ammo on everything. The Corsair with homing is pretty decent. Gotta remember that the homing only works on some of the bullets, not all of them. And so, like, you get a volume-based, proc rate, but that's alright. We died in bullet hell. I still consider this a victory, because we made it all the way down to bullet hell. But with that, thank you all so much for watching. If you like what you saw, let me know. If you want to see more, don't forget to subscribe to keep up to date on when I post more videos. And if you really like what you saw, leave a like. Helps the channel grow, helps me out a great deal. But of course, with that, thank you all so much for watching. I'll catch you guys in the next video. Bye!